What's up guys, welcome back to another day at sea, and today is a video about the bridge of biggest ship in the world. I have come here specially on second officer's watch. He's the watch keeper right now. I'm just here. There's no traffic around, so we're not interfering with his job for watch keeping. So special thanks to him for letting me make this video.
There he is. Beautiful, thanks.
And he's so making a route for us passing close to India. Right? So let's start, guys. This is a bridge wing console. So this we use when we are going alongside. So the captain and the pilot, they have all the controls over here. So I'll just give you a brief about the controls here. We have the engine telegraph used for the speed. Then we have a small rudder control system here. It's known as the remote control. Then non-follow-up buttons. Then we have the bow thrusters and the stern thruster here. Then some pressure gauges, RPM. Then depth below keel, we have a VHF which right now is missing. He's fixing it. Then we have a telephone. This is a manual powered telephone. We have PA system over here. And then this is a searchlight which we have on top on the bridge wing. And these two screens are for, let me show you. Screens are for the reference purposes. This is a radar relay. It's the S-Pan radar, and this is for a control system, like when we go alongside, so we need some for the reference for the captain for docking. We have some panels up top. This is the wind measuring instrument. This is the speed, then heading, rate of turn, and some alarm panels and sound reception device. So that's how a bridge console looks, bridge wing console looks. Then we have a man overboard release system over here. Then we have the gyro compass repeaters. These are known as repeaters, and this is known as azimuth. We take this azimuth to take bearing of the land object or a ship. So it's used for that. So guys, this is a chart table, and since we've gone paperless, so we don't use any charts. So we just have our logbooks and a few checklists and paperwork equipments and paperwork things over here. So that's how we start. Then we have a GPS. That's GPS number 2. That's the AIS. Then we have the EGDIS. This is our secondary EGDIS. I don't know why on the GoPro it's coming black screen and then white screen. So maybe it's some technicality which I don't know about. Then we have the radar. It's the S-Pan radar. Yes. Then radar, you must have seen in all movies what it's used for. This is the substitute for paper charts, so it's now electronic charts. Then next we have VHFs. VHFs are basically for communication. So if suppose there's a ship over there and we have to talk to that ship, so we use this and then we communicate. Then we have our autopilot system over here. Rate of turn, rudder angle. And this control is used to switch over from manual steering to auto steering and hand steering and non-follow-up and some and stuff like that. Then we have our screen over here, which is the ICS screen. From here we can see all the parameters of the engine, controller, light systems and many other things. Then the normal steering gear, non-follow-up, then sound reception system. Sound reception system is basically if suppose a ship over there blows its whistle, so we get to hear it on this. It also tells you the direction from which the whistle was blown. Then the telegraph over here. Then we have this telegraph bridge maneuvering system which is connected to the telegraph. So we don't have to go into the technicalities of this. We just use it for fine-tuning our RPMs. Then we have this compass monitor which is required suppose gyro 1 fails. So we have two gyros, so we switch over to gyro 2, so that is what will switch it over. Then we have this emergency telegraph system. You can see this. And this is the depth indicator. So we have a Rolls-Royce powered bow thruster and stern thruster, which I don't know, must have costed them a lot. So it's Rolls-Royce. So there's a dream of buying a Rolls-Royce car, and on this ship we have a Rolls-Royce powered stern thruster and bow thruster. Move on to the speed lock, then the echo sounder, then we have the steering gear pump changeovers. So steering gears are pumps are basically the pumps required to move the rudder. Rudder is the thing which is helping the ship move left, right. Over here, so we can press for whistle, gong, and you know, you must have studied rules of the road. So we require some sound signals during anchorage, and you know, when we go, if we run aground and stuff like that. So it's from here. Then we have some demo consoles. Basically, at night when everything gets dark, so we don't want much light going into our eyes. So we dim all the equipments over here. Then this is the magnetic compass right here. The helmsman, he controls the helm from this. There's a course indicator. That's the magnetic compass right over there. Then we have some panels. This is the telegraph. Oh, this is not telegraph. This is rudder indicator, rudder angle indicator. Same thing over there. Then rate of turn. Then waypoint. Then some alarms. Then wind indicator. Speed indicator and the clocks. Expand radar and the EGDIS. This is actually a repeater of the primary EGDIS. Primary EGDIS is behind. I'll show you about that later. And again, some VHF repeat rolling tanks control. On this ship, we have anti-rolling tanks which are fitted in the aft. So these valves controls are from here. So guys, a few other important things which we are left with is this SART. It's known as search and rescue transponder. That's the primary EGDIS. So as I told you, second officer Sean, he's making a route from
Dubai
to China.
Yes.
So that's him. And so guys, second officer is in charge of making all the routes and passage planning on this ship. So he's the one updating all these books over here and all. Nowadays it's paperless, so Sean, can you tell us how you update in just a brief?
It's very easy, you know. Yeah. It's you get this update file from the internet, and then you just apply it on the EGDIS. It yeah. updates pretty much itself.
So yeah. Guys, as you heard, nowadays not like you have to keep a chart and then you have to cut and paste stuff. So it's all electronic, digital, from the admin. Wellback now, it's Wellback.
Yeah, right? From the Wellback.
So
yes.
Wellback is sending all of this to us, and then he is updating all of it. GPS number 1, clock, that's our computer. The GMDSS stands for Global Maritime Distress Safety System. So from here we have the SATC, as you can see, two SATCs, and we have a MFHF. Console. MFHF is basically medium frequency, high frequency. For ships which are greater than 200 nautical miles, we use this for communication. Then we have a light panel over here. Gyro fin roll stabilizer. Then the fire alarm panel. So in case there's a sensor which detects smoke or fire, so it comes up over here, and then we take action. Then then we have again a VHF telephone. And all this controls. Behind we have some light switches. Then again bell and gong panel. Then we have this VHS, portable VHS. So in case we have to go on a lifeboat, we carry this. So then we have a room over here, which has some radio station switchboards, and then all the VDR and gyro switch box, gyro compass switcher unit. So VDR is voice data recorder. It's like a black box on an aeroplane. So if aeroplane crashes, for the data to be extracted, we have these black boxes. Same thing, we have something on ships known as VDR. So it is recording all of the things which are necessary. So in case there's some emergency or something bad happens, we have that to, you know, remap and recap what exactly went wrong, so that doesn't happen in the future. So guys, like I said, bridge, is the heart and soul of the ship. It's all serious business over here, because safety of navigation is the first thing which is the priority, and that's why I've taken special permission from the second officer and the captain to make this, and it's my non-watch keeping hours, hence this video. I hope you guys found this video informative, and if you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and do subscribe to the channel. I'll be showing you more about the vessel and, you know, whatever happens on a ship and at sea. So I hope you guys are finding this informative and something different. So yeah, stay tuned.